It's Tuesday, July 24th or 25th, 2017, and we planted more basil out there. There's a bunch of purple seeds. That one stake right there is where a tomato plant's going to go. Right now there's no tomato plant. There's a hole where I'm going to put it approximately. We got purple seeds of purple basil. Plus I've planted about 10 or 8 green basil. I actually have little plants to the left there. Alright. It'll come up on this camera. Can't really tell. But then I planted like 2 or 3 around those broccoli back there. Each plant had 2 or 3 basil plants put down. And then I planted some up here on the edge of the grass. Over by the tomato plants over there, I planted like 2 little basil plants next to each other right by the tomato plant. And I'm just trying to hold still because I had some hummers right up by me here and I was trying not to scare them off. They're over there in the garden. They're flying around. See, they like when the flowers come out here. See those orange torch sunflowers back there. They go by those all the time. Those are, they like those, it seems like. So do the big-winged butterflies, which is cool. See, now all the butterflies, not all, but this year has been a little unusual. The cucumbers here, this is the last week of July. And I'd say the longest one's about 24 inches, and there's 5 there. The other one might be 19 to 20 inches, and then there's 3 that are just maybe 3 to 4, 8, 5 inches. They're not growing very good. In Ohio, my wife's uncle, I think she said, he said his cucumbers weren't going good at all. There's a large winged butterfly right there. I've seen maybe, honest to goodness, total, 6. Large winged butterflies, and in the summertime usually we'll have like 20, 30 of them at a time on those orange torch sunflowers back there. And it's, I don't know, again, not everybody pretty much knows. I'm always talking about negative, but you know what? I'm sorry. Hey, nothing's growing. It's not growing like it usually is. Has. You know, I go from 25, 30 butterflies out here to seeing like maybe 8. Since the beginning of the year. And then we've got three or four of those little yellow ones once in a while flying around. And that's it. Usually there'd be like dozens of them things around the roads, but the cars are killing those. Because, you know, man's here first and man needs to be here, not nature. But, yeah. I put the flowers out there to attract butterflies and bees. The bees have been on the sunflowers pretty good. A little bit on the torch, mainly. That's I like that for the hummingbirds. We have a feeder out there and a feeder out in the number 3 garden there for the hummingbirds also. So the one cantaloupe was split. That one's no good. We got another one growing over there. We got 3, looks like sugar baby watermelons out there, and one long watermelon. There were 2 other long watermelons, probably, let me see if I can zoom up, you know, about that long, that all of a sudden just started getting black. Yeah, that's amazing to me, you know. And I put fertilizer out there, liquid fertilizer, right, and everything coming up pretty good with that fertilizer. But, you know, there's no way you can't say that things aren't right. So, tomatoes, we've had hornworms on them. We've got brown spot on them. Been pulling the leaves off there, but we're getting quite a few tomatoes good. Not a lot, but, you know, pretty good. We had 9 tomatoes we picked off already, of which only 2 of them have gotten red, and that's since, like, the beginning of July. We got 3 here. You know, and that's a certain type. I can't remember. Again, they're all heirloom, so that's a certain type of tomato. That's been picked with the other 7, other 6, which of the 6, 3 of them starting to turn red. One of them is almost red, but the others are, there's 2 others that are turning red, and the other is just green. So, but it's normal, I guess, you know, because, you know, hey, they can spray the hell out of the skies for decades and decades and put Monsanto with genetically modified food-like product growing out of the ground, but everything else is going to be fine. So go back to sleep. Don't worry about it. Enjoy your Monsanto. Enjoy your genetically modified food. What are you going to do? You can't get away from it. Yeah, just so shut up and eat it. Anyway, so my lettuce is still growing. them back in again. There's four of them out there. Three there, and then my butter crisp. There's a Hummer right to my right, so I'm not moving right now. Okay, he flew off. I was gonna get him on video, but being this close and moving, they fly off. But like the ones out there, I can stand here and talk, and they'll move, get on those. But anyway, I got a small hole break up against that sunflower out there leaning. Like I said, I broke up ground, put seeds down there, and then I put some green basil out there also. The purple basil is a great, that's over in number one garden, which smells so nice. I'm going to zoom in. I don't know if it'll come out good on the video. It smells so nice. It's in the back there. I don't know if you can see it. It's in the middle of somewhere on the screen. It's hard to see on the brightness out here. But, you know, that's the program. You don't get to see details. You don't need to worry about. We don't worry about what happened in the past. We just got to keep looking to the future, so you'll keep repeating the same damn mistakes. See, and they keep telling that lie. We can't worry about the past. We got to keep moving forward. Well, the saying is, if you don't remember the past, you're destined to repeat the future. If you don't remember the past, you're destined to repeat it. And if it's bad and there are mistakes and you don't remember it, oh well, just keep going, because you'll keep making the same damn mistakes over and over and over. And that's what those Satanists, satanical people in Washington, D.C., because that's what that is. That is a sewer, a cesspool. It is the most vile wasteland of things in there that lie to you, and you keep voting them in. It makes you stupid, period. Because you don't think, you just do what they, but they're going to do it this time. This time it'll be different. We're going to do this because this time it's going to change. Uh-huh. Jesus Christ, man. I've heard that my entire life. And I don't believe it. So I guess that makes me not as stupid as the majority of the people I've seen. Enough of that. See that? All that about my garden. I'm talking about the government being as corrupt as it is, that you should know. And you're practicing cognitive dissonance because, you know, oh, it's not that bad. Yeah, whatever. Take a loaded pistol with a hair trigger and put it up to your head and pull the trigger. It won't be that bad. Trust me. Trust me, it won't. Dumbass. Now watch, some ass will do that and say, oh, he said so in the video. And if you're that stupid, well, you deserve the final result of that one. No half-ass intelligent person would ever do anything like that. You don't have to be smart, but unless you're a fucking moron, stupid as dog shit. You know, dog shit might do it, but other than that, I wouldn't see anybody else doing it, a person. But again, if you do, have at it. Ta-ta, my battery light's flashing already because this stupid-ass, shitty-ass, what is it, the gun? I have to look at it for a second. Sony. It's a Sony. Looks like a 35mm type. You use like a 10-minute video and boom, 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 boom. It's 8 minutes and 23 seconds right now. Sony, they suck. In name only, that's all they are.